starting off as a symbol of my unity with everyone of Catholicism. Just a beautiful rosary a roommate of mine gave me. And a few times throughout this coming video, we'll pause for a moment. And I want you to reflect on love, because that's what God Jesus was. Born again, when he says in the Bible, you must be born again, that's to inflame our love. Because without love, we have no light, and our future bodies are made of light. So when the Bible says those who love are born of God and know God, because God is love. So somewhere along the way, things got messed up, and people started thinking you had to believe something in order to be born again. When all along, love has always been the driving force. When Jesus was out there, he was inflaming love. It had nothing to do with believing, and nothing other than love, because he is love. So we can't see the forest for the trees. The message got lost. And I'm going to prove beyond a shadow of a doubt, and this shall make all history, that a distortion spiritually came immediately as Christianity stole the blessing of Israel in a prophecy that was never understood until now, nor has it ever been proven until now. The new covenant is immediately associated with Jesus Christ, because it was a covenant addressed to the Jews, and it was always addressed to the Jews. It's still addressed to the Jews, and it portrayed a loving God giving an unconditional covenant that could never be broken. He says so, and he says it's eternal, and it's eternal over all people of all times, or else it's either true or God is a liar, because that is what his own word says, is that it's eternal. Anyways, what happened, and I'm just giving a synopsis, is all of a sudden Christians said, nope, he's not just the atonement, which he was, and he's not just the mediator, which he was, Hebrew 8, but they said he's the total fulfillment thereof, and they snubbed everything Jeremiah said. They ignored his prophecy, and then they committed identity theft, and they became Israel. And they became a God of love who had one condition: if you didn't believe in him, you went to hell. This was an invented God of love. He was totally misunderstood. And that is apparent because God never changes. There was no conditions in the original message of Jeremiah, and there would never be any condition added. That is under the threat of every curse of the book of Revelation, as John said. If you add to God's word, there is a severe consequence to pay. A huge distortion was made. Things were reassigned and not understood. And the prophecy of the new covenant, which I shall explore, proclaims itself to not have any addition. Because all of a sudden, when Christianity grabbed this and stole the birthright, just like Jacob stole it from his brother Esau when Isaac was blind, that's exactly what happened here. And the blessing of this new covenant of no condemnation, of God without borders, no conditions, he can be yours if you believe in him. But I'm telling you, if that insertion was valid, what I'm going to say now is not true, but it is true. Now, Jews were looking for no condition. God promised it. And then all of a sudden he became a liar and inserted that there was a new surprise addition that they had to believe in. What happened to, oh, Israel, I'm going to give you a new covenant that has no conditions? The second that Jesus Christ was being force-fed down their throat, that broke the everlasting covenant of God because mankind added their own words to God's words. Maybe I'm sitting here thinking, do I even need to make a video about this? Because I still am, to go a little bit more in depth. But if one thing is clearly understood, let it be this, that millions and millions of people have changed sides. And all of a sudden, instead of being a Christian, fully believing in Lord Jesus Christ, who is the Lamb, who is the risen one, who is love, all of a sudden, and nothing about religion and Christianity really makes any sense to them because it's been all mixed up. And then they become an atheist. Praise the Lord for atheists, because these people knew something smelled pretty rotten. And what's rotten is the invention of a false god of love with conditions. Love has no conditions. Love is forgiveness. When that covenant was given to all Israel, it was always all Israel. That meant all flesh, as God says in Jeremiah 20:32-27. And that meant all nations are his, as the book of Revelation says, when the seventh trumpet sounds and the mystery of God is over. It is over now. The assertion has been made. The invalid man has invalidated God's everlasting covenant. So you know what? You could not insert nothing in between God's eternal words. That he, it started off, it was a message to from our God of love to all flesh, which would have included all the Christians, which would have included all the Islamics. The prophecy was misunderstood, and God knew it would happen. This was his mystery, that a huge distortion was made when prophecy was not understood. But the original deal that the Hebrews offered was much sweeter because there was absolutely no conditions. God says, I'm going to be your God, you're going to be my people, which means I guarantee I will never send you to hell, I will never I will always forgive your iniquity and forgive you forever. That was a much better deal than believing or not believing, conditions that mankind put in there. Christians, listen, he is the mediator of the covenant. He stood silent all through his life on the book of Jeremiah because he knew that was his word. So all of a sudden, Jeremiah proclaims the most beautiful words and then he gets snubbed. Everybody ignores him because there's nothing more to know. This is the destiny awaiting for those who believe. No, no, no. That's a huge contradiction. He promised, if he broke his word to the Jews, he'd be a liar. He promised, I'm going to give you a covenant that cannot be broken. So double-mindedness of man, you can't have a condition where people are, maybe he is, maybe he isn't, maybe he is. So guess what? The new covenant is activated. Thus saith God by the latter day prophet Daniel foretold in Malachi 3:1. And by the way, Armageddon.Owsley@gmail.com, spelled Owsley. Please send off today for the last testament of Christ that conveys the distortion of the spirit of love, because the Christian God of love is the correct God. He is a God of love, but he's unconditional, as the Hebrew prophecy proves. Because the Hebrew prophecy was the true prophecy, and there was no conditions. And he says, as a result of this, to stop all the foolishness of man, to hit the big reset button. And he says to all man, once I unveil myself as unconditional love unto all peoples, then nobody shall need to learn any more of me. Because once you realize he's unconditional love, We can put the candles out. Religion is obsolete. Paul says so in Hebrews 8. And he was talking about the new covenant because, you see, because God named it the new covenant, everything before it, including the kingdom age, New Testament of Jesus Christ, it's obsolete too. Because the word of Christ from Jeremiah exceeded his own voice because there was no conditions as it always has truly been. Huge reset. And Jesus is kept in reserve in heaven until the restoration of his word, Acts 3:21. Peter knew it would happen. Paul knew it would happen. Bible twisting happened. And a new God of love was invented when the old God of love was more loving. There was no barriers. All Israel will be saved. Romans 11:25-27. I am the Lord God, the God of all flesh. Jeremiah 32:27. And when Revelation 10:7 happens and the mystery of God is over, Google it. All nations are the Lord's. And the book of Zechariah says, and in the days of the branch, Donald Trump, who's going to build that temple, in those days, all Judah shall be saved. All people have always been saved. God said so 3,000 years ago. The whole gospel of Jesus Christ has been misunderstood, misappropriated, because Christianity became Israel and stole the promise. I just fully woke up to how a new God of love could appear, and it was right there in the stolen blessing of the second covenant. And now the Lord says in the latter days that he gives that latter covenant literally, word for word, so that his gospel is always the everlasting gospel Revelation 14 that he puts into the earth, that goes before, and the white horse of the book of Revelation rides, and he has a long bow, and he has one arrow, and that one arrow is Elijah of Isaiah 49. And he said, Elijah, I'm going to give you the truth. I'm going to polish you up as a sharp arrow. And he says, I'm going to only need one arrow, and I'm going to go out conquering. Wake up. The loudest alarm against man's disease of disunity is now ringing out as the Lord's loudest thunder of truth. It's echoing in the heavens since mankind's crime of the ages, stemming from misunderstanding a simple prophecy, gave the world a false God of love. And that's finally been proven by the written word of God, so that the great restoration of Acts 3:21 can finally happen exactly as it was foretold by Peter the Apostle. The Word of God verifies the New Covenant's truth of salvation in Romans 11 to all Israel, to all flesh, to all nations, to all Judah, not just to Christians. All means all. And if good enough had been left alone, Jeremiah's message was heavier than Christ because of the twisting of love by adding a condition that Jesus Christ never made any condition that people had to believe in him. This was an exaggerated truth that people have just misunderstood. He is love. If people believe God is love, he is love. They believe in him even if they don't know him by this name or that name. There's hundreds of names of love and Jesus and God out there. He is not a petty God that's going to, oh, he didn't know the right name. Bzz, that's it for him. Anyways. And all Israel would be saved in the last days of grace according to the Bible with all eternal life as it has been given now. And all Judah will be saved, as Jeremiah 33:15 stressed. And if people would have understood the true message of love, peace would have exploded even in old times, since the Lord stressed in John 10:16 that all of his other folds of people all over the world with different religions would hear his voice of love, his true voice of love, unconditional love, and they would be accepting the salvation that they were already given from him. They've already have something. And he predicted in the last days that he'd be pouring out his spirit on all flesh, and that there would only end up being one flock. They would all hear his voice, and he would be the good shepherd over all as he brings forth peace. He is the rider of the white horse. Christ rides amid three evil horsemen who would end up killing billions of people if they won't listen to the Lord's messenger of Jeremiah. For that is all that I am saying. I'm saying that God said what he meant, and he meant what he said, and absolutely no insertions could possibly be put in. So receive now love from love, peace from peace, and joy from our eternal joy that comes forth as crowns of happiness for all viewers from any religions. Everybody love everybody. Will Ferrell from, what's that movie, Elf, he's going to be the new world leader. And everybody love everybody. That's his I kind of borrowed his religion. But no, love is the only doctrine of true religion. And people are going to know that the Black Lives Matter movement shall be transforming all over the globe shortly into an All Lives Matter movement, because God is offering us deliverance and freedom from the Great Tribulation to rescue us from his terrifying anger that he promises he will turn back if people listen and give his heart's desires. So love is going to be exploding like fireworks all over the world, and it's going to be by his word of love that brings peace where there has been none. I am just a sounding board. I have Elijah shall restore all things, and that is what I'm doing. Is God is bringing this world to a reset button written in his word, so I cannot add one word to his word as it has happened. And boy, the blood that has come from that little mistake. And Lord Spirit of Truth now brings restoration of truth to all men, where so everyone can finally see that our histories have all been desolate, according to Isaiah 49:8. We've had empty histories because we didn't understand the Bible's message. So let those of love send off for my free kingdom age work. It's called The Last Testament of Christ, armageddon.owsley@gmail.com, and it's spelled Owsley, O-W-S-L-E-Y. Just email me with or without any e-transfer donations, no problem. But let those who are wanting great hope now come to see that it's the awaited time when they can finally know why Jesus said in Matthew 17 that he'd send his last Elijah to do this, to restore his word. I'm Daniel, latter day was foretold in Daniel 12:9-13, I'm him. And I'm the one that the word of God has sent with his gift of interpretation of his prophecy, who would restore everything by his words, love's word, our God's word, without me inserting any words into his words. The cardinal sin was created by early Christian fathers who stole Israel's identity. Theft happened. We are Israel, and that is our prophecy, and it is fulfilled. No, he was a giver before. He was the mediator. He was the atonement. He was giving it to all. It was a fountain of salvation freely offered with no condition. And then his followers says, no, but you got to believe in him. Whoa, 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 whoa. It started about love. And then they took off the hats. And then off fell the hair. And then it was a whole new ball game. And it was nothing like it originally started to be. It was twisted. And love became a different love, a love with conditions, a love with secrets hidden that had to be revealed. So people, let us never forget that God is love, and those who love are born of God and know God because God is love. There is no religion in that word. And you know what? There is no religion in truth. God sees no religion. God sees no Jewish or Gentile, no Christian or Hindu. We're all the same, and he loves us all the same. So people, I'm here to set some records straight that should be common sense, that would get rid of racism if only people will listen to the Lord's word of love. I really was prophesied, and I'm going to be a little redundant here. I really was prophesied in Daniel 12, verses 9 to 13. And I'm the one the Word of God has sent. I've got his interpretation of prophecy. And for that reason, our living light of love now brings us all a great magnifying glass in these days of the great trial of all flesh that was foretold in Revelation 3:10. For it's the season of our Lord's trial over our twisted understanding about his unchanging word of love from his ancient new covenant of Jeremiah 31. So to be a little redundant here, please let the wise not hesitate in emailing me for their free book with or without e-transfer donation. Armageddon.Owsley@gmail.com. And again, that's spelled O-W-S-L-E-Y. Owsley. It contains a lot more evidence of the validity of Jeremiah's Christ-centered word of love for absolutely all loving people, and not just for people of one religion over another. That is why restoration must happen. That is why God says it is time to go back to Jeremiah's kingdom age word, because that was written for absolutely all flesh, as Jeremiah wrote in his covenant. Finally, the world can plainly see the truth about the new covenant of Jeremiah 31, verse 33 to 35, and God's law in general by YouTube's video called, and the video is called Breaking the Law of capital YHVH. You can't pronounce that one. Jewish. Breaking the Law of YHVH. Excellent. And this video is from their Mind Forward channel. And this masterpiece is from Anna, the sister of Shiasa from YouTube's House of Beloved, who I keep lifting up because of what she has done. And anyways, and don't miss her own masterpiece called Armageddon. It is finished on YouTube. Those extraordinary videos from those two sister sibling YouTubers are wonderful, since they're equally anointed to be presenting the holiest of all holy truths that's awaiting us all in the Lord's presently unfolding kingdom age of peace. It's starting, people. The new age is upon us. But it needs to be understood by the prophet Jeremiah alone, that early Christians adding their words to God's words through him unknowingly did create a global thick distortion of gross darkness of Isaiah 60's prophecy. The gross darkness would cover all flesh, because God's true message of his unconditional love to the Jew and to all people and to all nations was ironically wiped away by Christians incorrectly. That's the biggest irony, introducing a God of love, and it creates nothing but headaches where none should have been. If only they would have left Jeremiah's word alone and not inserted the unwritten insertion, but you got to believe in Jesus to have all the blessings of this new covenant, which were never added for a reason, because Christ is love. But it was after that man-made clause was added, even though God said in his word therein that his new covenant wouldn't have any conditions that could ever be broken. And he had said that because it was his eternal covenant of salvation over all flesh. It's always been there. And early Christians also just simply didn't understand. It's not their fault. They were following their hearts. They did nothing wrong. They misinterpreted prophecy. But the covenant that was promised through Jeremiah was a far better one than they were imagining. So they naturally ignored all of his prophecy as being a word of Israel. Then they added their own conditions as they committed identity theft, to use that term again and again, and Christians became the spiritual Israel. This is huge, because I'm 100,000,000% right that our Lord of Love's veiled kingdom age message of his unconditional love wasn't understood at all. And it was meant to be veiled. That was his mystery of Revelation 10, verse 7, that is now over. And for that reason, just as the Lord gave the Ten Commandments twice, so too does he now give his new covenant to all flesh twice, once more, so they can finally get it. It's never been any joke, but instead it's only been his most solemn vow unto mankind eternally that was never understood, because no one looked at it with the correct eyes of prophecy. Thus saith the Lord God of Israel, I shall now give my new covenant of Jeremiah 31 to all flesh, as I promised to forgive evermore the wickedness of all flesh and remember it no more, exactly as it has always been. For my children's living love changes not, for his mercy's forgiveness is the Lord. So let those of love please send off for my free kingdom age work. It's called The Last Testament of Christ, armageddon.owsley@gmail.com. And again, that's spelled Owsley, O-W-S-L-E-Y. And please just email me with or without any transfer donations, which are greatly appreciated. I'm waiting for $1,000,000. I know there's a rich sheik out there in the Middle East that's got my name on there. And don't forget, ask questions. I'm Daniel. I am the Lord's foretold Elijah, who now proves that God never wanted his new covenant to have any insertions of people needing to believe in any of his truths that were really true. Jesus is Lord. He is love, and he is unconditional love. And that has been obscured by the addition to his covenant that is all Christianity is based on. So, people, he left no conditions, so the people living in this understanding, this age of being able to understand some things better, that one might not be separated from another, that we've all had the same understandings. Love is the only doctrine that he has ever decreed for any of his creation. So let everybody love everybody, as Will Ferrell coined. So once again, please email me at armageddon.owsley@gmail.com. And again, that's spelled O-W-S-L-E-Y. And let those of love now come to see that it's a gospel truth of his living word, that such an added condition that was added by Christianity to his new covenant of Jeremiah, that such an added condition of believing in that forthcoming Prince of Peace, who really is that guy, could not have existed within Jeremiah's new covenant as Christians have taught, since that would have caused God's promised eternal covenant to be broken any second any believer became an atheist. This is indisputable logic that can never be overcome, because it is a truth that the Bible proves. End of story. Stop. pause, smell the flowers. The Bible proves that no insertion of any condition could possibly have existed there. God's word spoke that into existence, and anything stuck there sticks out like a peg in the wrong hole. So let's stop all the insanity. For the truth is that Christians like myself long ago falsely accepted a much worse false message that promoted the deaths of millions who didn't believe like us, instead of the right message of our salvation coming to all of us by God's mercy, because nobody of any schools of theology remotely understood the true Hebrew prophecy of Jeremiah. That's always been overflowing a fountain of living waters of love's absolute forgiveness over all Israel and all flesh and all nations. And Jeremiah clearly wrote that, and we have all ignored it. I am the messenger of Malachi 3:1 that prepares the way for the messenger, even the messenger of the covenant that Malachi says. And I am Jeremiah's messenger. Nor did any expert stop to consider the fact that Christianity projecting their faith into Hebrew scripture has caused undeniable evidence that God's eternal covenant was misappropriated, wrongly designated, incorrectly applied, and it was interpreted wrongly as spiritual Christians somehow became the Jews. Identity theft. It's a real mess that our love is finally straightening out once and for all for everyone within his kingdom age, to let his unconditional love shine as Jeremiah foretold. For here is the big difference. This end time prophecy makes anyone believing the proper Hebrew prophecy interpretation of the pre-Christian new covenant of Jeremiah that had to have included all flesh being spotlighted for salvation. At the other end of the spectrum, the incorrect Christian insertion of that new covenant, it's always meant death for not everyone not believing the Christian belief. One doctrine is right, one is wrong, but only one teaching is literal, and that one is Jeremiah's true covenant of no conditions, as it was written by that weeping prophet. Roars our Lion of Judah from out of Jerusalem. And his spirit of prophecy now says loudly that God promised Israel a covenant that could never be broken. For that reason, not one condition was written in his Old Testament new covenant of Jeremiah. But it came to pass that Christians believing their own faith was God's eternal covenant had them to claim that Israel's promised latter-day covenant was wrongly their own. And they stole the prophecy, since Jeremiah's prophecy has always been written exclusively for Israel, with the rest of mankind throw in a much better deal for us. And the real truth has always been that the Christians falsely inserted into Jeremiah's Kingdom Age New Covenant the teaching that people had to believe in the Lord. They had to believe that he was divine before they could receive any promises, any benefits at all from that word of God through Jeremiah. If you didn't believe, you didn't inherit, no. Then the message of the Lord's unconditional love for all flesh was lost to the world due to Christians mistranslating the prophecy of the Jews that they were outright stealing as their very own. I'm being a little redundant saying it in a few different ways so that it sinks in here. This is what caused a distortion of multiple gods of love. Some gods of love having absolutely no conditions, unloving, unconditional love. Others having conditions, and everybody had to go to hell if you didn't meet those conditions. No, what was promised is a covenant that could never be broken, which means a covenant with no conditions. And otherwise, if there were conditions, that Jeremiah's covenant would be invalid every time people, believers, become atheists. That would break the eternal covenant of God. So it proves that this is not true. So let those of love send off for my free kingdom age work called The Last Testament of Christ at armageddon.owsley@gmail.com. And again, that's spelled O-W-S-L-E-Y. I'm also looking for a few e-transfers, small donations, if people appreciate my ministry. It's very expensive to get on camera. Anyways, what happened next was that a false god of twisted love with some more conditions right then and right there was replacing our true Lord of the Hebrews, who was revealing his absolute unconditional love over all flesh. A false god of love stepped in as his end time prophecy now clearly proves. The Bible proves this is true. Logic proves this is true. And love is love. There should be no more arguments. That's why the covenant says, and people shall have no more need to know anything more about me, thus saith God, once they realize he is really unconditional love over us. Then religion can end. You know, God always wants love in every religion. He's not out to destroy us or hurt us. He wants religions of whatever to flourish as long as everything is love is the only doctrine. Everybody love everybody. Will Ferrell is the new king of earth. Everybody love everybody. It's all his fault. Anyway, so don't forget to email me again. It is Man's Survival Guide of Surviving the Apocalypse That's Ahead. Armageddon.owsley@gmail.com. Again, that's spelled O-W-S-L-E-Y. Anyways, 2,000 years ago, it came about that Jeremiah's purest word of Christ's endless love was then ignored as being the fulfillment, wrongly, of the new covenant's prophecy when it never was. Then his true word of man's eternal covenant was all misinterpreted and ignored, since only arguments were suddenly found in that misunderstood end time word of God. But the most ironic thing is that previous to Jeremiah's word being interpreted by false prophecy interpretation of misguided believers in our risen Lion of Judah, the Lamb of God, who is the Lord, he was clearly prophesying through Jeremiah that all future Christians and all future Islamics and all future loving people would all be inheriting everlasting salvation along with the very best things from their Heavenly Father's kingdom of love, as long as they kept their love lights burning so they would never commit blasphemy of love. Because when the light goes out, we could never have a spiritual body in the afterlife, because it is made of light, his glory. So Christianity replaced Jeremiah's word, and that is what Jeremiah's word proclaimed. Listen to it yourself. So stop the presses, I have to repeat this. The Lamb of God was clearly promising that everyone would inherit this, as long as people keep their lights on. So that's all we need to do. Love is the only doctrine. Everybody love everybody. And that is why the error of God's new covenant has to be corrected back to that point of restoration by his command, as it was foretold in Acts 3:21 by his apostle. Because ignorance crept in and people distorted, and they became destroyed by their lack of knowledge over a misunderstanding of one verse alone, which was the most important message in the whole Bible, God's solemn covenant between him and all mankind, which was and is and always shall be unbreakable without any insertions. So then Christians said to the Hebrews back then, no, you can't have what God has already given you. You can't have what God has already given you. And they had to accept a condition when God said there's not going to be no condition. He said, I'm going to give you a covenant unlike the ones of your fathers, no conditions. And there was none. Jeremiah wrote it. But then we changed things by the religion of man. Anyways, it's a rock solid fact in our Lord's word that his eternal inheritance has always been for all of those of all flesh, from all religions and all nations, as it proves in Revelation 11:15. Look it up. That's what's happening right now, as foretold. And our Lord's latter-day new covenant has finally officially been activated in these days by his last foretold Elijah. And unless the hearts of the fathers turn to the hearts of the sons and vice versa, this earth will be destroyed, according to Malachi 4:6. So, quit concealing things by ignorance. Get ready, because I'm going to tell everybody about a not-so-funny thing that's happened along the road of history that finally fully explains why God's word has to be restored to its original meaning before unlawful additions to it by good-hearted people entirely changed everything. It created a huge distortion when the real meaning of God's everlasting gospel could never change. So please understand that our Lord's word of his great restoration now returns his word to Jeremiah's earlier time. That restoration, a reset button, so we can now understand why such a correction has always been so desperately needed, as Peter taught in Acts 3:21. And again, armageddon.owsley@gmail.com, O-W-S-L-E-Y. Please send me some questions. Let me know someone's alive. I've been hidden for 20 years. Anyways, so let the nations now learn about our Lord's corrupted eternal new covenant in a little bit more detail for those that want to. And this is from our guardian of forever, who is now declaring that nothing or nobody could ever keep anyone of love from love, as Paul later on wrote in Romans 8. 38-39, back when Paul says, I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things believed or not believed, things present, no, I added that one, nor things to come, nor height, nor depths, nor any other creature shall ever be able to separate anyone from the loving, born of God, who is Jesus our Lord. He is love. So let those of love again send off for my book, armageddon.owsley@gmail.com, O-W-S-L-E-Y. So now I need a drum roll, please. Oh, Farrell, where are you with that cowbell? Anyways, I shall now prove the biggest problem in history first began when Christianity stole Israel's end-time prophecy of Jeremiah 31. A huge divergence in history got away from the truth. And then Christians even committed after identity theft, and after they became spiritual Israel, the message stopped being for all flesh, as Jeremiah was proclaiming. And the bittersweet truth is that again, I've mentioned it, but they stole the blessing, just like Jacob stole the blessing from Isaac, from his brother Esau. There was a stolen blessing there that happened. And in early days, when Christians wrongly created a condition and they put it unwritten in that written, it's always been unwritten, even though it's written in the Christian canon to help those who aren't religious to understand. But by inserting that they didn't realize that canceled out all of God's promises. It made the covenant breakable, and that was never his intentions. But since Christians said there was a condition, it was totally discounted, everything Jeremiah said, and he quit being viewed as an end-time prophet, and all the prophecy about the house of Israel stopped being about the house of Israel, and it became about, there's us. That's us. We're Israel. Woe to those who change God's word. And there's been a lot of woe in Christianity that needs to be reset by that reset button of his kingdom age. Oh, and I got to mention people right here that proves everything I'm saying about Jeremiah is Jeremiah 1, verse 10, where he says, Jeremiah, I appoint you to be over all kingdoms of the earth, to tear it all down, to tear down everything by man, the religion, the governments, everything, so that the kingdom of God can be built and grown. He is alone the kingdom age prophet of restoration. I am but his messenger. Armageddon.owsley@gmail.com. Owsley. Everybody love everybody. Will Ferrell is king. But all this stuff that I'm talking about, fact separates itself easily from any science fiction that people of early Christianity and history wrongly created conditions and put them where none should have been. But logic screams out that such conditions that were added to his unbreakable have to be stopped and have to be reversed, because nothing can be in their conditional that would deal with our double-mindedness, because we're double-minded about anything, especially if we got to agree whether Jesus is divine or not. That's why, praise God, it no longer matters whether he was or wasn't. He happens to have been. As far as I'm concerned, I am always raised as a Baptist, a Pentecostal, a charismatic, a fundamentalist. But you know what, folks? I'm diverting away from what I'm saying here. But the truth is, I am Islamic, I'm Buddhist, I'm Christian, I'm Hebrew, I'm whatever. Wherever truth is, I'm truth. And if there's deceit or fluff in any religions, that don't bother me. I know the truth. God is love. And it ends right there. That's why the New Covenant says, and no one shall need to know anything more about me. Thus saith God, the New Covenant of Jeremiah. Read it for yourself. Anyways, God was never a liar, and that's why no insertions could have been put in there that could have been broken. So, you know, Christians becoming atheists have happened all the time because Christianity hasn't made sense, because it has become distorted. Anyways, if you want to look a little harder and deeper, I'm going to give you one more idea about something. Here's what happened, one event after another. In the beginning, it came to pass 700 years before Isa, Yeshua, Jesus, finally came, Jeremiah, the weeping prophet of Christ's word, this is his word, people. He came forth as our good shepherd's eternal new covenant writer. And he was put above all the Lord's different flocks of different loving people. And he confirmed, the Lord confirmed that in the last days, all one flock would happen from all the different folds in John 10:16. And that's why Jeremiah wrote, and all flesh, that says the Lord. When God says, I am the God of all flesh, that means there's a belonging. He ain't going to let you go. If you're his, you're his. He loves you, and forgiveness is love. It's a fallacy that there has to be conditional love, because love is forgiveness. You can't extract forgiveness from love. That's why God is a liar if he sends one person to hell, because his word says, I shall forgive all your iniquity, and I will remember it no more. So on Judgment Day, if he remembers it, the God I'm serving is not a true God of love, not a true God of unconditional love, as Jeremiah plainly has written. So let those of love send off again for my book, armageddon.owsley@gmail.com, Owsley, and I am looking for $10 million from some sheik in Araby. And the word of God from Jeremiah's new covenant, folks, it was the living atonement over Jesus. In that holy agreement, he was the atonement, he was the mediator, and he was the giver of a covenant. When Christians added, he stopped being a giver of a covenant, and he started being a receiver of his own, who wasn't a giver of anything to all flesh. Anyways, the wording of that unconditional new covenant was written expressly for the children of Israel, and it purposely had absolutely no conditions, and it to be a little bit redundant is good. And that's so that no terms could ever be broken, so his word could never be broken, because Moses prophesied, God is going to give you an eternal covenant. And then when he did give you the eternal covenant, he said, and this is the new covenant, the eternal one that could never be broken, which means no insertions. And it was given to him to tear everything down. And so it was that our Lord's new covenant of the Old Testament then established his unbreakable forgiveness of all sins over all children of Israel, over all time periods, for all people, of all nations, of all flesh, of all Judah, of all Israel, exactly as Romans 11, 25 to 27 says. Paul wrote that in the days of the book that I'm trying to get you guys to send off for, it's the fullness of the time of the Gentiles, containing partially a huge section, 1,500 pages of quotes of the Gentiles. But when that comes, he said, all Israel shall be saved, which means all flesh would be saved, by the way. Same thing. And that's because of the covenant that God made with Israel, is what Paul foretold. And he was talking about the new covenant of salvation for all men that we all possess, always have possessed, and all of our religion has been but a social club. Isaiah 49:8, read them and weep. I am to reassign our desolate heritages, so people understand why mankind, the wall of mankind, has gotten so crooked that it's ready to fall down. One little from God, it's gone. We'd be toast. But he's got lots of mercy, so don't get your dander up. But folks, our Prince of Peace's word of faith was then given through Jeremiah. Everyone of love, their eternal security, if they had listened to his voice. But they did not listen. It was obscured. Everything was obscured. There was a veil that was created. There was a false god of love. And that masterpiece that he wrote of prophetic masterpieces was written in the blood of the Lamb by Christ's spirit of love, so it would bring forth peace and love's truth unto all people of the faith of love. That is the reset button. Everybody love everybody world. But things only became distorted instead. We didn't understand what God's message to us was. No one had the gift. Emmanuel, our God with us, he was freely giving out through his prophet Jeremiah. Love was giving abundant life, hope, and a promise of an awaiting Eden that was ahead for all of his loving children from all flesh, as he doth the Lord stressed in Jeremiah 32:27. And as the Apostle John warned, Christians ignored his advice, and they added anyways their insertion, their unwritten insertion, oh, but you got to believe in order to have that new covenant. When by wrongly contradicting Jeremiah's word, the true message was entirely wiped away, and then an invented, egotistical, false Jesus of love came, one that had conditions. You had to give him glory. You had to believe in him, or you were toast, buddy. No mercy. And that's a huge condition that the Jews were expected to believe. I wouldn't have that crap rammed down my throat. My boots aren't deep enough for that kind of crud. That's a huge condition. And the Hebrews were told that you're going to have a new covenant that unlike what your fathers had, one that can never be broken, one that you must believe in. No, he became a quasi-lord of unforgiving love who was wrongly an egotistical lord who would only be receiving his very own followers. He stopped being the giver of a covenant to all flesh and to all nations. And the light was hidden under a barrel. And the word of God from Jeremiah became a metaphor. Poetry can't be alive, can't be power, can't be applied to anyone's life. It's pretty, it sounds nice, but it lacked any oomph because it was never understood to be literal, because it was ignored, because a shroud of distortion covered the earth and gross darkness covered the earth, exactly as Isaiah 60 foretold. But now the Son of Righteousness arises with healing in his wings. He is unconditional love over us all, exactly as Jeremiah proclaimed. And I proclaim that the false god of love is a false god of love, and that only the unconditional love of the true covenant of God stands alone, because nothing could ever be inserted that could be disagreed with. So anyways, a holy pause in remembrance of the fallen ones of the Black Lives Matter movement. And I encourage them, be weary not in well-doing. And the day is coming when you shall arise in an All Lives Matter movement, more than has ever been imagined. And it shall happen in the streets of every major city in the world by love's command. People, if my message of Malachi 3:1, the messenger of the covenant, who I am, if I am ignored, that would mean that the forthcoming Messiah of almost 4 billion Christians, Jews, and Islamics won't even be able to return, as Peter the Apostle warned everyone in 3:21. So listen up, people, please, and get my book, armageddon.owsley@gmail.com, Owsley, O-W-S-L-E-Y. Thus saith the Lord, Spirit of Prophecy. Some real toxic changes were made by early followers of religion to the word of God's prophesied new covenant of Jeremiah 31. Nor did it matter that early Christians were some well-meaning people who didn't understand that end-day prophecy that's secretly always been in effect over all people anyways, ever since God first said, "Let it be." Then ignorant people of the past wrongly added conditions to the Lord's written word. And their additions would be teaching that people had to believe in Christ in order for them to receive the Lord's blessings of everlasting life that Jeremiah 31 was already promising them. That was a big change. And to be a little repetitive, it's really obvious that such a condition of believing in our true Lord of love clearly could not have been truth, for Christ's original new covenant of Israel promised them no conditions ever, as I've said, so nothing could be broken. And their imposed condition there of needing to believe in that Messiah would have caused again and again that covenant to be broken every time people become atheists. And I think I've probably mentioned that on purpose 3-4 times now in this video, because a lot more than 3-4 times do believers in the Lord Jesus become atheists, millions of times, because love has been twisted and misunderstood and changed by mankind. The God of the Hebrews is the God of love. So to throw your religions at the door and just be prepared to be energized by love. Everybody love everybody. Love is the only doctor necessary. But folks, again, I'm going to risk being a little redundant here and tell you that what actually happened back then was that baby Christians, when they arose and they said that Jesus wasn't just the Word, he wasn't just the atonement, he wasn't just the mediator. No, that wasn't good enough. They goofed. They went a step further, and by stealing Israel's identity and not understanding the Jeremiah's prophecy, it's totally changed everything. So anyways, this is the complete restoration in the hearing of every single person of every single religion. And God loves you all. But woe unto those who do not exalt only brotherly love, because it's never going to last in this day and age, because this is the revelation that mankind has been waiting for. Our God is love, and he's all forgiving. He's all merciful. As long as we keep our love light on, and he promises to return his terrifying anger if we give him the desire of his heart to show a little love. If we show a little love, we can change the world. So it wasn't good enough to early Christians that the words blood, the Lamb, was the mediator of that new covenant. But because they said, no, he's the total fulfillment, then, folks, you have to see that he quit being just a giver of a covenant to all flesh, and it became a receiver of his own. So, folks, I just want to add one thing. Everybody love everybody. Again, armageddon.owsley@gmail.com. Get my book. Send e-transfers, please, if you can. No problem if you can't. But this is about love. Everybody needs to love everybody. Will Ferrell is my king of comedy. Someday, maybe he'll endorse my program. But the bottom line, folks, in summary, I just want to add this. Nobody maliciously intended anything. Nobody purposely did a real criminal action. It was a misinterpretation of the Word of God. But nonetheless, it was, even though an innocent misunderstanding is how this all originated, but nonetheless, it's caused a huge distortion with multiple gods of love. Which God of love do you like? Well, I like that guy love, that guy love. I don't know, he's kind of talking about hell all the time. That guy love. But the God of love talking about hell all the time, people, if Jeremiah's word is true, the new covenant, and it is utterly true, that is why the Lord is now telling us for the restoration that we need to go back to that new covenant to build things straight, to build things right. And by the decree of that new covenant, thus saith the Lord, people, I'm going to forgive all your iniquity, all your wickedness, and I'm going to remember it no more. There shall be no hell awaiting you. If I send one person to hell, I would be a liar